What is adjoint and how to find the adjoint of square matrix? In today's class, I am going to discuss about how to find the inverse of square matrix. In that, we have one theorem on the inverse, that is, a matrix is said to be invertible if and only if it is non-singular matrix. Non-singular means determinant of the matrix is not equal to zero. If the matrix is singular, then the matrix is said to have inverse. And if the matrix is invertible, then the matrix is non-singular matrix. So to find the inverse, we have a formula in the determinant, that is A inverse equal to 1 by determinant A into adjoint of A. So let us consider one problem to find the inverse and also to verify the theorem A into adjoint A equal to determinant A into I. For that, we have to find the determinant of the matrix. First, find out determinant of the given matrix. So, determinant of the matrix is equal to. Now, expand the given matrix along the first row. So, in that first element is 1. 1 is the first row and first column. Delete its first row and first column. Remaining elements 4, 3, 3, 4. And determining value of those 4 elements are 4 4s are 16 minus 3 3s are 9. Middle sign is minus and the second element is 3. 3 is in first row and second column. Deleting first row and second column. Remaining terms are 1 3 1 4. So 1 into 4 4 minus 1 into 3 3. And the third sign is plus. Third element is 3. So 3 is in first row and third column. Deleting first row and third column, remaining elements are 1, 4, 1, 3. By taking the cross product of diagonals 1 into 3, 3 minus 1 into 4, 4. So simplifying these, we get the value as 1. First, we have to check whether the matrix is singular or non-singular. Here the determinant value is 1. So it is not equal to 0. So the matrix is non-singular. Next we can continue. Next we have to calculate the adjoint of the given matrix. Adjoint means transpose of the cofactor matrix. First we have to find the cofactor of all the elements of given matrix. So let us consider the first row. For first row, cofactors are A11. For first element, cofactor is capital A11. For that, we need to multiply minus 1 power 1 plus 1 with corresponding minor. Here, first element is in first row and first column. Delete the first row and first column. Remaining elements are 4, 3, 3, 4. So, here minus 1 power 1 plus 1 is 2. That is even. So, minus 1 power even is positive. So, 1 into 4 4s are 16 minus 3 3s are 9. So 16 minus 9 value is 7. Next consider for second element. For second element cofactor is A1 2. So for that we take minus 1 power 1 plus 2 into corresponding minor. Here 3 is in first row, second column. Delete the first row and second column. Remaining elements are 1 3 1 4. So this is the minor of second element. So minus 1 power 1 plus 2 is 8. So it is negative. Now 1 into 4, 4. Minus 1 into 3, 3. 4 minus 3 is 1. 1 into minus 1 is minus 1. Next consider the third element. For third element cofactor is A, 1, 3. So minus 1 power 1 plus 3. Third element is in first row, third column. Deleting first row and third column, the elements left are 1, 4, 1, 3. So minus 1 power 1 plus 3 is 4. That is even. So 1 into 3, 3. Minus 1 into 4, 4. 3 minus 4 is minus 1. Next consider the second row. So for second row, cofactor denoted as A21, capital A21. In that for first element, that is in second row, first column. So minus 1 power 2 plus minus 1 into 3 4s are 12, minus 3 3s are 9. 12 minus 9 is 3, 3 into minus 1 is minus 3. Next for second element, 8 to 2, minus 1 power 2 plus 2. So for 8 to 2, 4 is in second row, second column, deleting second row and second column. Remaining elements are 1, 3, 1, 2. Minus 1 power 2 plus 2 is even, so it is positive. 1 into 1 4s are 4, minus 1 into 3, 3. So 4 minus 3 value is 1, 1 into 1 is 1. Next, 8 to 3. For 8 to 3, minus 1 power 2 plus 3 into corresponding minor. So your third element is in second row, third column. Deleting second row and third column. Remaining elements 1, 3, 1, 3. So minus 1 power 2 plus 3 is odd. So it is negative. So 1 into 3, 3. Minus 1 into 3, 3. So 3 minus 3, 0. 0 into anything, 0. Next comes the third row. For third row, corresponding minor is A31. In that first element is in third row and first column. Delete the first row and third column. Remaining elements are 3, 3, 4, 3. So here minus 1 power 3 plus 1 is positive. So it is plus 1 into 3, 3 is a 9, minus 4, 3 is a 12. 9 minus 12 is minus 3. Next consider the second element, A32. So second element is in third row, second column. Deleting third row and second column, we get the minor as 1, 3, 1, 3. So minus 1 power 3 plus 2 is odd, so it is negative. So 1 into 3, 3, minus 1 into 3, 3. So 3 minus 3 is 0, 0 into anything, 0. Next, last element, A33. So, A33, it is in third row, third column. Delete the third row and third column. We get the elements as 1, 3, 1, 4. So, minus 1, 4, 1 plus 4 is 4. It is even. So, 1 into 1, 4 is 4, minus 1 into 3, 3. So, 4 minus 3 is 1, 1 into 1 is. So adjoint of the matrix is, so adjoint of A is equal to, directly I am taking the transpose of cofactors. So that is first row, cofactors comes to the first column. 7, minus 1, minus 1. And second column, minus 3, 1, 0. And third column, minus 3, 0, 1. Next we have to check A into adjoint A is equal to determinant A into I. For that we have to take the product of A and adjoint of A. And this is adjoint of the matrix A. First we have to multiply the matrix A and adjoint of the matrix. Consider first row and first column elements. Multiply first row elements with corresponding first column elements. So here 1 into 7, 7. 3 into minus 1, minus 3. 3 into minus 1, minus 3. Next consider first row, second column. 1 into minus 3, minus 3. 3 into 1, plus 3. 3 into 0, 0. Next first row, third column, third element. 1 into minus 3, minus 3. 3 into 0, 0. 3 into 1, plus 3. So next consider the second row and first column. 1 into 7, 7. 4 into column, second element. 1 into minus 3, minus 3. 4 into 1, plus 4. Plus 3 into 0, 0. Next, second row, third column, third element. 1 into minus 3, minus 3. 4 into 0, 0. 3 into 1, plus 3. Next, consider the third row with three columns. Third row, first column, first element. 1 into 7, 7. 3 into minus 1, minus 3. 4 into minus 1, minus 4. Next, third row, second column, second element. 1 into minus 3, minus 3. 3 into 1, plus 3. 4 into 0, 0. Third row, third column, last element. 1 into minus 3, minus 3. 3 into 0, 0. 4 into 1, 4. So simplifying this, we get 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. Already we know that determinant of the matrix A is 1. By taking 1 as common, again the matrix left with 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. So here 1 is determinant of the matrix and this matrix is identity matrix of same order and that can be taken as I. So the matrix product of A into adjoint A is equal to determinant A into I. Next we have to find the inverse of the matrix. For that we have the formula A inverse equal to 1 by determinant A into adjoint of A. So here determinant value of the matrix is 1. 1 by 1 into adjoint of the matrix is 7 minus 3 minus 3 minus 1 1 0 minus 1 0 1. So anyhow the determinant value is 1. No need to divide the elements by 1. So directly the inverse of the matrix is 7 minus 3 minus 3 minus 1 1 0 minus 1 0 1. So this is the inverse of given matrix. So next consider one more problem. Here matrix A and matrix B are given and we have to verify AB whole inverse equal to B inverse into A inverse. First we have to find the product of A and B. So take the product AB. So that is equal to 2, 3, 1, minus 4 and matrix B 1, minus 2, minus 1, 3. So first we have to multiply first row elements with corresponding first column elements. 2 into 1, 2. 3 into minus 1, minus 3. Next, first row, second column, second element. 2 into minus 2, minus 4, plus 3, 3 is a 9. Next, second row, first column. 1 into 1, 1. Minus 4 into minus 1, plus 4. Next, second row, second column, last element. 1 into minus 2, minus 2. Minus 4 into 3, minus 12. So this is equal to 2 minus 3, minus 1. Minus 4 plus 9, plus 5. 1 plus 4, 5. Minus 2 minus 12, minus 14. So this is the product AB. So next, we have to find determinant of AB. Minus 1 into minus 40, plus 40, minus 5, 5 is the 25. So 40 minus 25 is equal to minus 11. Next we have to find AB whole inverse. For that we can use the formula A inverse. A inverse formula is 1 by determinant of A into adjoint of A. Similarly AB whole inverse equal to 1 by determinant of AB into adjoint of AB. So here determinant of AB is minus 7. And in 2 cross 2 matrix directly we can take the adjoint by interchanging the elements of this diagonal and changing the sign of the diagonal. No need to interchange the elements, only we have to change the sign of this diagonal and we have to interchange the elements of this diagonal. So the adjoint of AB becomes minus 14 minus 1 and here sign changes to minus 5 minus 1. So this is the adjoint of A. So here all the elements having minus, so by taking minus as common, minus minus get cancelled. So this is equal to 1 by 11 into 14, 5, 5, 1. So take this as equation 1. Next we have to find out B inverse into A inverse. For that we need A inverse and B inverse. First find out the determinant of the matrix A. So determinant of the matrix A is equal to 2 folds of A, minus is there, so minus 8, minus 1 into 3, 3. Minus 8, minus 3, minus 11. Next, determinant of B. So determinant of B equal to 1 into 3, 3, minus, minus 1 into minus 2, plus 2. So 3 minus 2 is equal to 1. So next consider A inverse. So A inverse is equal to 1 by determinant of A into adjoint of A. So A determinant value is minus 11 and adjoint of A, change the first diagonal, change the elements of first diagonal and change the sign of second diagonal. So the elements becomes minus 4, 2 and by changing the sign minus 1, 3. So this is A inverse. Next consider B inverse. So B inverse is equal to 1 by determinant of B into adjoint A. So 1 by determinant of B value is 1 and adjoint of B is, so interchange the element of this diagonal and change the sign of this diagonal. 3, 1 and by changing the sign 1, 2. So this is the B inverse matrix. Next we have to take the product of B inverse and A inverse. So that is B inverse A inverse is equal to, so here 1 by 1 is 1. No need to take that. So directly take the adjoint 3, 2, 1, 1. And that inverse of A is 1 by minus 11. Take it outside. So 1 by minus 11 into adjoint of the matrix is minus 4, minus 3. And second row, minus 1. So next multiply this matrix with this matrix. So 1 by minus 11 into. So first consider first row, first column elements. 3 into minus 4, minus 12. 2 into minus 1, minus 2. Next first row, second column. 3 into minus 3, minus 9. 2 twos are 4. Next. Second row, first column, first element. 1 into minus 4, minus 4. 1 into minus 1, minus 1. Next, second row, second column, last element. 1 into minus 3, minus 3. 1 into 2, plus 2. So that becomes 1 by minus 11 into minus 12, minus 2. Minus 14, minus 9, plus 4, minus 5, minus 4, minus 1, minus 5, minus 2, plus 2, minus 1. So all the elements having minus. So by taking minus as common, minus minus get cancelled. So B inverse A inverse is equal to 1 by 11 into 14, 5, 5, 1. So take this as equation 2. So from the equation 1 and 2, We have proved that AB whole inverse is equal to B inverse into A inverse. So this question can ask for 5 minutes. Next, consider the third problem. So here the problem is like this. Show that the matrix A satisfies the equation A square minus 4A plus I equal to 0, where I is 2 cross 2 identity matrix and O is 0 matrix, which is also of 2 cross 2. And again, we have to find the inverse using the equation. First, we have to check that matrix satisfies this equation. First, we have to find the term A square. So, A square can be calculated as A into A. So, here the matrix A is 2, 3, 1, 2 and 2, 3, 1. So, multiply the elements of first row with first column elements. 2, 2 is 4 plus 3 into 1, 3. Next, first row, second column. 2, 3 is 6, 3, 2 is 6. Next, second row, first column. 1 into 2, 2 plus 2 into 1, 2. Next, second row, second column, last element. 1 into 3, 3 plus 2, 2 is 4. So this is equal to 4 plus 3, 7, 6 plus 6, 12, 2 plus 2, 4, 3 plus 4, 7. So this is the A square matrix. Consider the equation, LHS of the equation, that is A square minus 4A plus I. So here A square value is 7, 12, 4, 7 minus 4 into A. So A is given matrix 2, 3, 1, 2 plus I is identity matrix of order 2 cross 2. That is 1, 0, 0, 1. So here 7, 12, 4, 7 minus. Multiply all elements by the scalar 4. 4, 2 is 8. 4, 3 is 12. 4 into 1, 4. 4, 2 is 8. Plus 1, 0, 0, 1. Now we have to subtract or add corresponding elements. So here consider first element 7 minus 8 minus 1 minus 1 plus 1 0. Directly I am calculating 0. Next consider second element 12 minus 12 0. 0 plus 0 0. Next for third element 4 minus 4 0. 0 plus 0 0. Next last element 7 minus 8 minus 1 minus 1 plus 1 0. So this is the 0 matrix and we can denote it as 0. So the matrix satisfies the equation A square minus 4A plus I equal to 0. Next, using the equation we have to find the inverse. So don't use the formula of A inverse. We have to use this equation to find the inverse of the matrix. Consider the equation A square minus 4A plus I equal to 0. So here we have to shift the terms. Keep the I here only and shift the remaining terms. So that becomes 4A minus A square. Now for this equation, we have to post multiply by A inverse. Post multiply by A inverse. So next the equation becomes I A inverse, which is equal to, for each term we have to multiply A inverse. So 4A into A inverse minus A square can be written as A into A and again we are multiplying with A inverse. So I into A inverse is A inverse only, because if we are multiplying any element with identity matrix, then we get the same matrix. So A inverse is equal to, and we already know that A into A inverse and A inverse into A is equal to I. So this is equal to 4I minus, here also we, by combining these two, A into A inverse value is I. So A into I is, again we get the matrix A. So now substitute the matrix I and A value. So 4 into identity matrix is 1, 0, 0, 1 minus A is given matrix, that is 2, 3, 1, 2.